Hello friends, my name is Tanvir Sheikh. I am working as JRF at Agarwal Research Institute and I am working on soybean breeding project. Today I am going to talk about marker assisted breeding. So let's begin with an example.
Can you pick the red apple mixed with the basket full of green apples? It became easier to find the odd apple with red color marker. Here, red is a marker for color trait. Similarly, plant breeders use modern DNA sequencing techniques to identify DNA sequences associated with desired traits. Plant breeders cannot directly replace the whole variety that farmers prefer. Instead, they improve one of any deficiency which occurs in any trait by using marker-assisted breeding. They determine the entire genetic makeup of the plant and develop new traits using natural variation or artificial induced variation such as induced mutation or genetic engineering. Marker-assisted breeding is the process of integrating these improved traits into the varieties by series of crossing, testing and confirming at each step. Soybean is agronomically very important crop as it is a resource of edible protein and oil. It also contains many nutritionally important components with a range of applications in pharmaceutical, baking and food industries. But it also contains anti-nutritional components present in soybean seeds, especially protease inhibitor and lipoxygenase. These are major deterrents in widespread acceptance of soya foods. Conid's trypsin inhibitor is the major proteinaceous anti-nutrient, which is strong inhibitor of trypsin and affects the digestion by hindering protein hydrolysis and activation of other enzymes in the gut, and it may lead to pancreatic hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Lipoxygenase is another enzyme present in soybean seeds, causing lipid oxidation, resulting in formation of off-flavor in soybean foods. Both Conid's trypsin inhibitor and lipoxygenase needs heat inactivation for improved nutritional quality of soya foods, but it incurs extra cost and also affects the solubility and functionality of proteins. So, we are focusing at eliminating these anti-nutritional components to increase soybean consumption, enhance nutritional values, and develop new industrial uses of soybean. For this, we use marker-assisted backcross breeding approach in which DNA is simply isolated from young plants, analyzed for DNA markers associated with desired trait locus, and based on the results, selected for next round of crossing. We do foreground selection for target locus based on gene-specific marker and background selection for accelerated recovery of recurrent parent genome using linked codominant SSR markers. Checking the DNA markers in large plant population is all it takes. Genetic removal of anti-nutritional components and enrichment of nutritional values will significantly boost utilization of soybean in foods and also combat the diseases stemming from mal and undernutrition and reduce health risks. This is the major step towards ensuring global food security and to meet nutritional requirements of growing population while retaining the biodiversity of our natural resources. Thank you for watching this video till the end.